Siche, so it might take a little bit longer, but we'll start. Yeah, we. Okay. Hilik Yud Aleph, Siche Beis. The Keshel Makas Orev, Shevi HaKadosh Baruch Hu Mitzrayim, concerning the Makke of Orev, which, as we know, Orev means a mixture, but it means that Debesha sent a mixture of wild animals to roam around Mitzrayim and with biting and killing, etc. So concerning that makkah that Eibishter brought on Mitzrayim, the super parasha saying that the Torah tells us in this week's parsha, Shakadosh Baruch Hotziva L'Meishe Leim L'Parei Hashem commanded Meishe to say to Parei like this: Ki im ein chomishalei chasami, if you're not going to send out my nation, hineni mashliach b'cho geimer asorev. So the literal translation, as it would seem, mashliach would mean send. But as we'll see in Rashi, mashliach here doesn't mean send. Mashliach b'cho means I'm going to entice to on you es ha'orev, the mixture. U'molim b'tei Mitzrayim, and they're going to fill the houses of Mitzrayim. U'molim b'tei es ha'orev, the orev is going to fill the houses of Mitzrayim. V'gamo adomo asher heim oleo, and also the land which is on it, which means that there will be full a big mixture of wild animals. And they're going to go roam around and do it what wild animals do. They're going to bite and kill. This is the pasuk. Rashi beperusha. Rashi in his commentary. Ma'atik min hakosov as atevis mashliach b'cho. Rashi quotes these two words from the pasuk. Mashliach b'cho. Umefarash and itay chesuis. What do these two words mean? It means megare b'cho, that I will entice to on you. B'chein. Rashi adds a raya that this is the pshat from a different place. The pasuk says the shem behemis ach shalavom pasha azinu. It says the tooth of behemis of animals I will send to you. There it also doesn't mean send. There it means entice. Loshen shisui in sitter balaz in French, whatever it's called in sitter. It's loshen shisui. Now the word shisui is another word for enticing. Migare b'cho is enticing and shisui is enticing. But I just want to mention, and it's negated to the sicha later, that the word shisui means a harsher, a worse enticement than the word megare. Megare is one level and shisui another level. But that's what Rashi says here. That when it says mashliach b'cho means enticed. Over pashtas kavanosei, the pashtas, what is Rashi trying to tell us? Levayer wants to explain shatevas mashliach eini miloshin shiluach. That over here, the word mashliach is not sending. K'mei im eincho mishaleach v'ascholos kosev ze'atzmi. This posik itself, it starts off, if eincho mishaleach esami. There it means, if you're not going to send them. So, there it means sending, but the word here, mashliach b'cho, is not that. Elo shum loshen giri. That's loshen enticing. Al derech al tizgo rubom. The word that we find, the word giri in another posik that's later on, dvarim, which means enticed. The kamet yukim achich and pirush zeh. And if you Yudayukim forces Rashi to tell us that the pshat is not sending, but enticing. Why? Number one, im hashliach b'movim shel shiluach, if it means sending, chaytzarech lias kosev mishaleach, k'mei b'tchilas haposeg. Just like in the beginning of the posseg, im eincho mishaleach mesending, he should say, hinani mishaleach. Same, I will send. What's the yud there? Mashliach. That's number one. So assume it's not sending. Another thing, base. Loshen shliches masim yeser leimer mashliach esa'ore b'cho. If it would mean Loshen sending, it would rather say instead of mashliach b'cho es ha'orev, it would say mashliach b'cho mashliach es ha'orev b'cho. Why? This is a semeres. It means hanishlach. If you say I'm sending, first you say the one you're sending or whatever you're sending. Well, achaze lemihu nishlach, and then you say to whom it's being sent. Ukmei lekame, like later it says, shaleach es kol magifesa elipcho. I'm going to send all my plagues in your heart. So he says first what he's going to send, and then he says to what he's going to send. Mashleichim aloshin girui, if it's enticement, haretevas b'cho mechuberes l'mashliach. Then the word b'cho goes together with mashliach, means ki b'cho b'chelik ma'apul atzma. B'cho is not just telling you to whom it's going to go. That's an expression. When you say entice, I'm going to entice on you. So the on you is part of the enticement. Not only in you, the enticement will happen. We say that megarabe means you enticing him, the animal kadema, something like that. So if it would mean sending, it would say mashliach es ha'orev b'cho. It says mashliach b'cho, assuming it's part of the enticement. So it means enticing. Gimel. Ima moving the shlichas, if it would mean the lashon of shlichas, masim lemer mashliach lecha, sending is sending to you. Mashliach elecha, also to you. Lei mashliach becha, sent on you, in you. Aber im Ruhani gire, masim abita mashliach becha. If it's enticing, yeah, I'm enticing you. That's the way we speak. So that's three rayas, three reasons why Rashi learns that it means enticing. Mipnei beis taimim v'achreinim, and because of the two second and third reasons, ma'itik Rashi min hakosav gam teves b'cho. So Rashi, therefore Rashi, in the Dibur HaMaschil, he also quotes the word b'cho. Afshu hu mefarish rak teves mashliach, shepirush magare. L'chure, Rashi is just teaching here, what does the word mashliach mean? And Rashi, the way the Rebbe learns always, Rashi only quotes from the posik, the Dibur HaMaschil, the words which are negated to pshat. If Rashi is just teaching what the word mashliach means, he should have just quoted the word mashliach and say megare. He says, he quotes mashliach b'cho and he teaches megare b'cho. He should have just quoted the word mashliach and teach megare. Why does he quote the word b'cho? That's part of what is mashliach. Because the Rebbe always learns that Rashi quotes in the Dibur HaMaschil or a word that is the kasha, part of the kasha, or it's a word that's negated to the pshat that Rashi says. So here it's negated to the pshat. Rashi says megare, mashliach means megare. What part of the raya that it means megare, not send, is from the word b'cho. Sign number two, sign number three. It says megare, mashliach b'cho, not mashliach is or b'cho. And the second one, it says b'cho, not l'cho. So from that is a raya. So Kaponim, we understand why Rashi learns the way he learns. It makes sense in Pshuta Shel Mikra. Why he learns doesn't mean sending, it means enticing. But we have to understand in this Rashi. Number one, when he brings a raya from another place, that it means enticing. Why does he go to Parsha Hazinu? Why doesn't he bring to something earlier, which is in Parsha B'chukesai? There it says, which seems the same thing. I'm going to send to you the animals of the field and send. It also means entice. And b'chlal, when you have a raya from an earlier pasuk or later pasuk, you always go to the earlier one. Why skip that and go to the next one? So why does Rashi not bring the pasuk b'chukesai? The yeser yuksha, the kasha is even stronger. Not only is it because it comes first, but k'gedima lahavi kosvazeh gamitz prat neisiv. It would make more sense to bring this pasuk from a different reason. The makas ore varemedube begeiru chayes. By ore, we're talking about it is an enticing animal, chayes. It talks about behemoths. So it's not such a big kasha, but lopel, if you have two choices, why not bring a choice of a posig which is closer to the posig that you're trying to explain? So for two reasons. Or first of all, it's earlier, and second of all, it fits more to the teich. The second kasha, lachash apirish meloshim megara, after Rashi says that it's from the lotion of enticing. Why does Rashi have to add after that? He says it means megare, and then he brings that ayah from the pasuk shen behemis hashalabom, and then he adds again loshen shisui. What's he adding loshen shisui? He already said megare. She'ein lemer shebeloshen shisui kavanose levayru leparish megare. Chura, you could say maybe Rashi writes the word megare, but he's afraid maybe people don't know what megare means. So he translates it and he says, Megare means shisu. You can't say that. Key number one, Teva shisu eina yedua mavenes la Talmud yeser mitevis megare. The person is learning a Talmud. He doesn't know the word shisu, what the word shisu means better than megare. Adarabe, megare ubita nim tzakame pomim chum shateira. The word megare is written in the Teira a few times. Ve'eit shalosh and shisu eina nim tzahasapam b'chumish. The word shisu is not even once a chumish. It's a word in Lashon Kodesh. But not in the Chumash. Why would Rashi think that Megara person doesn't know and he has to translate Megara Shisa? That's number one. And the second thing, the Fize, if he's just explaining what Megara means, he should have written the word Loshen Shisa right after the word Megara and translate Shisa. And then bring the Raya from the other Pasuk. What Rashi does is different. He says Megara, brings the Raya from the other Pasuk in Hazinu. And then he goes back to Loshen Shisu. If he just wants to use Loshen Shisu to translate Megara, he would have said right away. And the third thing, If Rashi says Megara, and then he wants to teach us what Megara means is Shisui, Chatchila used the word Shisui. Teach us, what does Mashliach Becho mean? Meshasa Becho. Why would he write Megara and thinking that people don't know what it means, and then he'll add the word Shisui? So for all these reasons, it can't be that he's translating. So why does he write first Megara and then Loshen Shisui? The Eile Tare Shebisof Azu Bolu Dayek. He can't answer that by adding these words, Loshen Shisui is trying to be Medayek something. But like this. That even though the simple, the real translation of the word mashgiach, mashliach in itself is megara, wants to say the taich of the word is megara. But I'm telling you that in this case it was more than megara, it was loshen shisu. The lefizeh, you can't say it because according to that, adain kosher bezanal. The second kasher from before is still shver. He should have said the word loshen shisu right after the word megara. The same way he asked that on the previous shot, he's asking here also. If you're going to say that he's trying to tell us that here it was another level, a higher level, a stronger level of enticement, so as soon as he says megara, he should loshen shisu. Why does he in middle put in the posik from Parshas Hazinu? The eight hagufa minon. Other kasha. How does Taka Rashi know that? Shemashmos kandu gam shisu neisiv al megara. If Rashi means that, why? How does Rashi know? If the posik mashliach could be megara, how does Rashi know to say in this case it wasn't megara, it was worse, it was shisui? So you can't say Rashi is just trying to say that it was megara and it was really more than megara, wasn't shisui, for these quick questions. Right, lahal mamsha Rashi v'pirushi, Rashi continues in this pshat, ma'itik es ha'tevis es ha'orev, he quotes from the posik the words es ha'orev, mafarash and teaches us, what's es ha'orev? Kol min ha'chayis rois v'nechoshim v'akrabim barbuvi, all kinds of chayis rois, wild chayis, snakes and scorpions, mixed up. By mashchisim b'hem, and they were destroying them, they were hurting them. Then Rashi continues, yesh tam b'dover b'agodah, b'chol makel, makel lomazu v'lomazu. There's a reason in Agadat, in Agadat, in Chazal, what's the reason for every makel? Why did Eibush to bring this makel and this makel? And he gives the reason. B'tachsisim l'chomis melochim, in the plans, the way kings, when they wage war, bo aleim k'seder malchus. They go in the seder of the way it works, in the Seder of the Malchus, the way they fight a war. Eibush was fighting here a war with Mitzrayim, similar to the way the regular wars are fought. What is the regular style? When you besiege a city, first you ruin the wells, the water supply. Then you blow shofar and you scream, the yarim alam, to scare them, to mix them up. So the same thing here. So the second market was Tzvadeya. The Tzvadim, the Karkirim, the Humin, they make noises, all kinds of noises, similar to the second stage in a war, where they make noise and they sing. Rashi says, like it says, this is the next piece of Rashi. So the Rebbe says, we have to understand it. Number one, Rashi takes this from the Medrash. Rashi changes the Loshin a little bit. The Medrash, Yeshna, and the Geyla, Aminish, Makis, Eruv, Orev, these days. In Medrash, there are two opinions. What was this Makas Orit? One opinion is show you Dubim Arayas from the Morim, bears, lions, and leopards. Based, the second opinion is show you Tsorin Vitushin. These insects that fly and insects. That was Orit. Pinizesh Rasha in a Mafarat as a Chayas Rois Laminayim Kedeo Alad. The reason why Rasha doesn't specify which animals were in this Makkah of Orev, like the first opinion, which it says it was bears, lions, and leopards. Hatam Poshet, simple reason why Rashi doesn't. Ki mistapek b'zeh maskiru meteire makoli chayas rois. Rashi is enough when he says chayas rois, that's a general title. Or bifrat, shalati pshuta shalmikra ein hechrech, shal yachayas eladaf. Especially that in simple pshat, where do we see it was dafka these three? So Rashi says it was wild animals. Rashi doesn't have to say that. Certainly, Rashi can't learn like the second opinion that there were these flies, insects, bees, spiders, all these insects. That we understand also why Rashi can say. The Medrash itself says why that opinion is not so poshut. And it says like this. It says the Tzvadim died. They died and they stay there. They stunk up the whole city, the whole country. Why did the Eibush not care if they died? Because they have no use from it. It only is a problem. Aval orev shoy hano beir esayim. Orev, where you could use their skin, even if they would all die, you could use their skin. Lefirach le'nisher b'hem ad echot. That's for one, not even one was left. She'ilo ha'yitzirin v'yitush no'ilem she'yasricho. But if the orev was made of these insects, of these flies, then it's just like Tzvardeya. Then we'd have a kasha. The kasha is, why did the orev not die, but David should make them disappear? So if you learn it was animals, we understand why, Medrash says. Because they shouldn't have no use of their skin. But if it was these insects, why didn't they die? So that's a raya that it wasn't insects. So we understand why Rashi doesn't bring it. Umikim shagam Rashi nokat kamza bepirushay. Rashi says like the Medrash, that prat, that Rashi says, Rashi says that Oriv did not die like Tzvardim for the same reason, because he didn't want him to have an oar from the skins. So that makes sure that you can't learn the pshat that it was these flies, these insects, because it doesn't fit to the fact that they die, that they had to disappear and not die. So that we understand why he doesn't bring the names of the, like the first pshat, the names of what animals they were, and why he doesn't learn that they were these flies, these insects. But the fact that after Rashi adds, says the word that they were chayis royes, Rashi adds unuchoshim v'akrabim. It was snakes and scorpions. That's in the movement. That's not understood. If a mixture of many animals includes betzim, and animals means all kinds of animals, including snakes and scorpions, in kilom alei, why does Rashi specify? Just like the Rashi doesn't specify other animals, why should he specify snakes and scorpions if it's part of it automatically? It doesn't say what the chayis royes are, what animals were. So why does he specify this if it's part of that group? If the pashtas, snakes and scorpions are not included in the chayis royes, that's why he says it separate. He says chayis royes, and then he says snakes and scorpions because they're not included. So the question is, how gufesh, how you got nechoshim v'akrabim, and only tell us that it was nechoshim v'akrabim. If it's included, monish. If it's included, he doesn't have to say it. If it's not included, he also shouldn't say it because who says they were? Where did he get it from? That's one kasha on Rashi. The second kasha on this Rashi. Madu ha-mafarash Rashi dafki v'posik zeh she'yeshtam v'dover b'chol makom makel lamazu v'lamazu. Why in this posik, Rashi decided to ask and answer why if the Seder HaMakis was in this order? Why did he say it? Ask it here. If al pshat, you have to understand there needs a reason why he brought these makis. So you should have said in the earlier makis. The first makis. Why were these makis brought and why in disorder? Why did he wait till the fourth makis oriv? That he decided to say, why was the Seder in the Makkas? What's up is here? So Yashmer Forshim, some explain, Shabasholas Makkas and Hashem, Lehutzrach Rasha Levairas Taimon. Some of Forshim say, Sipschachomim, that in these first three Makkas, Rasha had no reason to explain, didn't have to explain the reason. Kimuvun humim Ashikosa ben Litnese, because it's self understood from what it says before. What does it say? Hamakkas Shodamat Svardeya him Berdei Lehalkas Ayodam, Ayodam Asirosam. The first two, Damet Svardeya, we understand, we have already a reason from before why they were the first ones. Because they were there to punish the Avedah Zorah of Mitzrayim. The Avedah Zorah of Mitzrayim was the river. And they both have a shaykhus to the river. Rasha says, by Gab Makas Dam, Mitzrayim made them Nilos, and the Mitzrayim worshipped the Nilos. The Fichar Hilkeh Asirosa. That's why first he punished their Avedah Zorah, the river which is the Nilos. And then he hit them. So there we understand why this is the first market. Because the first thing you do is you punish their Avodah Zarah. The Gamba market Tzvardeya Reksi Veshoras Hayev Tzvardim. By Tzvardeya also it says that the Tzvardeya, the frogs came from the Yair. So also it's part of the punishment of the Yair. The Gramba Rashi Mafura, Rashi says that this was a punishment for the Avodah Zarah, for the Yair. Rashi says that Vishahegin Ayir Al Mesha, since the Yair protected Mesha Rabbeinu when he was put into the basket, Lay Loka Al Yodi, that's why the Yair was not punished through him, Lay Bedam, Lay Bitzvadim, not with the blood, not with Tzvadim, because it says in Chumash, that who hit, who did Eibush say should hit the Nilus? So the dam will come and the Tzfaratim will come. Aaron should do it. That's just why it's not Moshe. Because Moshe shouldn't do it because he was protected by the Yair. So we see that both Makas have to do with the Yair. So the and the Yair, we know, is Avodah Zarah of Mitzrayim. So the first one was to punish the Avodah Zarah. Shagam Tzvadeh Makas HaYairi. So the Tzvadeh is also a Makas for the Yair. But that's not first, but second. And the Shalei Yair also Mamash Hulkas HaYodah. Because when the second Makas, it wasn't the Yair itself that was punished. It was something that comes from the Yair. So the first one was the Yair itself. The water itself was changed down. The second one is that Tzvadeh, what comes from Yair, also was punished. So it's a second Madrege. That's what came after Dam. So the first two, they say, Rashi doesn't have to explain why that came first and second. But again, Lamakas Kinim, and the third Makas Kinim, we also, Gambo Atama Vosa Muchach Minyona. The reason why it came, we could see from the Inyan of the Parsha. When that came, that's when the magicians admitted that this is the finger of Hashem. So the Eibusha wanted to do something to show that it's from Hashem. When Rasha came now to Makas Ore, Oz Hukshalei, so Rasha has a kasha. Loma Makas Udavke. Why is Udavke this Rake? That's what he gives the reason, because it followed the Seder of the way you wage war. Ulam Peter Ze Einim Movin Klal. This Pshat is not understood at all. And I mentioned many times, I'll mention it again. The Rebbe never liked to use the word like Klal. Usually, I remember when we used to write a word, this ain't a movement klal, he used to cross out the klal. Lagamre took out the word lagamre. He didn't like this word. Don't go to extreme. If the Rebbe does write klal, you know it's kasha. So this pshat that we said, the reason for the first three makas is not understood at all. Klal. Number one. According to what they said, is why does Rashi say it here? Because he's interested to explain why Makas Orif came. The other three he didn't have to explain because we have reasons. And this he came to explain why the fourth Makas came. Im kein, if so, eich yitochen shesatam l'makas Orif, ain't a maybe. The pale, what does he bring? It follows the Seder of Muhammad and he explains the first and the second. First you do the water, you ruin the water, and then you make the noise. And he didn't say anything about Makas Orif. He says at the end it's in Tanchum, and there you'll, if you look, you'll find it. The Feirish is a time of Shein Negel in Yanina. The Feirish, he brings the reason for Makas Dam and Makas Svadeya. But that's, according to that shot, that's not what he's trying to tell us. That we know from before. Why? So he's trying to explain Makas Orev, and that he didn't say. The second thing, Leidik is on the other hand. The svaras am aforshim anal bepirish Rashi. According to the pshat of them, those aforshim, shetameim shall give me makas and hashenim yidu mepshutim, that the reason for the first three is known and it's simple. V'lochen leizbiram Rashi b'derech shaylo lo makazu. That's why over there Rashi never asked why, because we know the reason for the three. So imkei madu achayze Rashi meisem atayim. Why did Rashi change his mind? What did Rashi do here? So before we said Rashi relies on the other three reasons. That's why it's not shver. And now he comes, he's looking for the reason of Orev. And he changed his shot from the first two. He gives now different reasons. He gives the reason for the two Makas for a different reason, because that's the way you wage war. So if he relies on those reasons, that's why he didn't ask it. So why all of a sudden he brings it and says the opposite? So the first kash is, he doesn't say anything about Orev. The second kash is, but the first three, he says a different shot. And Gimel, the third shaila is, if he pirish on now, according to this pshat, hemshech hadibur hazeh b'pirash Rashi, ach v'rak b'yir taimah shel Makas Orev levad. The whole reason why Rashi brings this is to explain Makas Orev. That's the behindu shu inyeh b'fnei atzmeh b'ein le'shaychez v'hemshech l'mashakosu lifnei zeh b'eisi hadibur kol min nechai Yisroel. According to that pshat, Rashi is going to explain a new thing now. Why did the Eibusha bring Makas Orev? But it has nothing to do to the first part of Rashi, that Orev means a mixture of all the animals and what is it? But you do a klal, we know the klal, the rule, the b'mok of Rashi Masbir, but the place where Rashi explains beis inyonim nifrodim, the perusha shel teiva achas et teiva sachodes ma'kosuv. No, a klal, and Rashi wants to explain a few separate inyonim, b'negei a word or a few words in the parsha, ozomaitik teiva zupamayim. Then he quotes the in dibur ha'maskel, makes a new dibur ha'maskel, and requotes the posik again, lifnei kol inyon b'fnei atzmei, before every inyon. In other words, if Rashi puts
in the same Dibur HaMaschel, two Inyonim, they must have a Hemshech. Okay, the real Makas Fadeya, like look back, Makas Fadeya, Shemaitik Tevis Ati Reda Pam. Rashi explains, Ati Mistaste. Rashi says two things there. So Rashi quotes from the Posik twice. First he quotes the Posik and then he explains one thing, then he quotes another thing. Alpizeh, according to that, Kamba Nidin Didan, Hoyle Rashi Laitik Esa Orev Eda Pam, but they lachalik, but Inyan Linyan. So here too, after he explains Esa Orev, what it means that the animals, the mixture of animals, he should have finished that Rashi. And then bring the Posik again, Esa Orev, and say, if Rashi, if their pshat is right, he's going to explain the reason for Orev. He should have quoted the word Esa Orev and explain Lo Mako Mako Make. A third shaila, but Tam Makas Dam, maybe Rashi Rakas Hamoshel. Concerning Dam, Rashi doesn't explain why he brought Dam. He just says in the Moshel is the way kings wage war. There he said the first thing is that they ruin the water supply. And Rashi doesn't tie choice that the same thing is here, that the water changed the dam. The Blila has been born in the Nimshel, which is the case of Makas Dam, he doesn't say. Which is similar to the second thing that they do by war, when they blow the shofars and make noise, there Rashi explains how it's negated to us. The Tzvardim also make that noise. Why by Dam, he didn't see Ruiz, just like over there by the kings, they ruin the supply of water. Here, they Abishar made Dam. He doesn't say those words. He just said what they do there. But Tzvardeya, he did. Just like they make noise, they Abishar made Tzvardeya for noise. Dalit. You can see there are six kashas here on this shot. That's why the Rebbe said, ain't a moving cloud. It's push it not. Fourth kasha. Mezesh Rashi Magnum Yeshtam Badover Ba'agode. Movement She'ein Apirish L'Kipshuta Shel Mikra. From the fact that Rashi starts off here, that there is a reason in Agode. Agode is mean the Agade from Chazal. That the reason why their demarcus came in disorder. So since Rashi, if it was this simple pshat and posig, Rashi wouldn't say it's Agode. Since he says Agode, right, it's not Pshuta Shel Mikra. Uchure, Aritam Zeh, Shakadosh Baruch, Betachsisim Lachomis, Chule Bo Aleim, Huinyan HaMesiyah Shekam Bepashtes Mevavish Shel Mikra. This is a simple pshat. This idea that David should follow the order of a war, that's a lot of sense. That's not Agade. That you can learn a simple pshat. Why does Rashi write that this is Agade? Hey, Loma Mesayim Rashi Kedisim Medesh Shetan Chumen. Why does Rashi end up by saying, as it says in Medesh Shetan Chumen, Harein Darkish Rashi Letzayin Amokin Ledvorov, Rashi usually, not his derech to show, to refer where he took his pshat from, the mokir, im lebe mokir shezeh negeya lepirush hakosuv. Unless this, quoting the source helps you understand this pasuk. U'mayin afkemina kan. So what here? What do we gain here by knowing that this is all in Tanchume? Gam alom acholke lishnai. Also, why did Rashi divide it into two parts? Kosa b'tchilas pirush sheyash tam b'dover ba'agode. In the beginning, he says there's a reason in agode, which is basically medrash. And he finishes off again, like it says, why does he make it in two things? He should have included it together and started. We'd have the time in Medesh, we'd know it's Septan Chumah. Why does Rashi make it two things? And the sixth shaila is, Rashi in this Dibur HaMaschel, this piece, explains what the word Orev is, Kom in the Chayas. Then he explains, why did he bring Orev? According to them, Rashi is explaining why it's Orev. The first three we know, but why Orev? So Rashi should have just quoted the word Orev. Why the word Es Orev? Harikor Perusha Ein El Beteves HaOrev. So he should have said HaOrev and explained these two things. Why did he say yes? It's all if the word, if the second part of Rashi is to explain why Orev. So it's not the gate to Es. Abirva calls it. So we have so many kashas here. Now, it's a long sikhin, and it's going to be a lot of protein here, so we have to halt cup. Abirva calls it. The explanation is going to take very long, I see. B'chol makim makim, b'neisim shalifni makim sorib, b'neisim shalachre. Every makim, beside the one before Orib, beside the ones after Orib, ha'ipri nusa v'teichan ein shemuvin nikir. What the punishment is of that makim is very obvious, very clear. How do we know it? Or if you look in the warning words that Pari was told before the Makkah, those Makkah, not every Makkah had a warning before. So those Makkahs where there's no warning, it's understood in the words of Hashem to Meisha, when he told him, do this and this, to bring the makkah. So from that we knew what the makkah is. What's the teichen? It means like this. Before it actually says the makkah came, we know what is going to be. Whether when we see what Moshe said at the party, he told him what he's going to do, clearly what it is, or from the words of David to Moshe. But before it says that it happened, we know what to expect. We know what it is. Shein kibem makas sodet. Makas sodet shebasar osel inemev. When the Eibishter warned, it says only, Elohim mishliach v'cho es ha'orev. I'm enticing on you. The orev. What's the orev mean? The mixture. That's orev. Omol abot ha'mitzrayim es ha'orev. V'gam adom ha'shem aleh. And the house of Mitzrayim be full of this mixture and also the land. Mebili le'edeinu mahu enyon neshom makas orev. It didn't say what orev is. Orev means a mixture. Arvuvia shoma, a mixture of what? Umal pranusa, how does that punish them? A mixture of what? Doesn't say what. And then why is that a punishment? If you bring a mixture, I'm going to make a mix up certain things. So big deal. How's that a punishment? And here we don't know what it is. That forces Rasha to say that it must be, Rasha says it in these words, mashliach b'cho es ha'orev. That contains what this maki is going to be. Because it's, otherwise we don't know what it is. Since from everything that's continued, we understand. We know one thing is going to be a mixture. And a mixture of something that will reach all over. It'll be all over. You in the Mitzrayim, in the Adomo. Loch and Pirish Rasha. That's what Rasha says. Mashliach b'cho megare b'cho. Shliach b'cho means I will entice. That means that the word mashliach means entice, that we already know. Shemitzada hechrach amuvelil sifalif lefarash mashliach megara yuvim gam mihu mahor. Based on what we said before, that mashliach doesn't mean sending. Mashliach means enticing. If mashliach is enticing and it says the mixture, now start thinking. What is it? What is the mixture? It's self-understood. Misha shayach v'inyan agir. Who do you entice? Animals. So if the word, since the word mashliach must mean enticing, and it says mashliach the orev, a mixture, I'm enticing a mixture. What it could be? Animals. And when we entice an animal, what do they do? If you entice them, you get them angry, get them to roam around and run around, they're gonna bite, they're gonna kill. So just from the words mashliach b'cho es ha'orev, we know what it is. We know it's a mixture of animals and how it's a punishment. HaKadosh Baruch Hu yigare b'alachayim hayra b'avuvia. Davish is going to entice a lot of animals in a mixture. And they're going to bite and destroy the mitzvim. Okay. Now we know that. So we know what orev is. V'hinei zeh sh'atayim mefaretes rak zeh shebo b'orev b'avuvia. Now we see an interesting thing here. That what the Torah does, it tells us the makkah. Now, the only word that the Torah says beferish, what's the makkah, is the mixture. Even though we understand from the posik, that means a mixture of animals. But Lapel, the Torah only picked out to mention the word the mixture. The kol ha'protish b'makkah, from all other details. The Torah doesn't even mention the main thing, that it's chayis. Now, we know that from the posik, from the word mashliach, but not from. From the word, that's not, in other words, not befeirish. It doesn't say befeirish in the Torah that it's going to be animals. The only thing it says befeirish is that it'll be a mixture. Machriach leimer shal deizeh yizbar adover shal yoyinu yeidim eisib lachov. The reason the Torah says the mixture, to tell us that there is something here that you would not know otherwise. And that's why the Torah mentions dafkidis. For who? What is that? The main nes and the main chidush in the fact that the animals came, hoyo shabo harbe mini chayis barbuvia. That's the main nes. The main nes is that all kinds of chayis come mixture, which is not normal. Obviously, wasn't such a big nes, something special in the other protim of this that the animals came. The main nes, the main abnormal thing here was it was a mixture. Being Cain. Mukhrach leimer, if we're going to say that, you have to say, shirak chayis hoye b'eirev b'lei b'hemes. So we have to say, well, only chayis, not b'hemes. Chayis, b'hemes are domestic animals. Chayis are wild animals. So since the Torah doesn't mention that the animals came, only Arvuvia, and the only way Torah says is I'm going to entice you, so it must be Chayas, not Behemoth. The Im Gam Behemoth Bo B'Shchisu V'Chulak Me'Achayas. If the, this case was that even the Behemoth, the domestic animals, also came running and destroyed, Haridover Zeh Chidush Godol V'Nesu Makazu. That's a big Chidush in this Makkah. Well, because of the Teves Oriv, Muchas Shekol Yikir HaNesu Raka Iruv, Iruv HaChayas. And from the Pasuk is Mashmah that there was no other main Nisim. If Behemoth came, it's a big mess. Taylor says the main ness is that they came, a whole bunch of animals came together. That's, but that the fact that they were biting, that's not a ness. But if behemoths would come, that would be a ness. So the Taylor should have mentioned that they were behemoths. I'm not these yuksha, but that will make a sakasha. If the only ones that were there were chayas, which destroy anyway, so why did they have to entice them? There's nothing to entice. Animals, if you let them loose, they're going to bite anyway. So if a behemoth, we need David to entice them. But like this, to be also behemoth, you have to entice them. They should destroy the opposite of their nature. Like chayas, wild animals, that's a teva. That's why to answer the shayla, Rasha says the word shisui. What he means is, even though the pshat of mashliach is megare, is girui, which is enticement, a simple level of enticement. That's a taich of the word. We understand there could be levels in how you entice. Yes, girui stam, there's a regular enticement which you don't have to do any, the chayas have it themselves. And yes, girui chozak anikra shisui, then there's a stronger enticement which is called shisui, shemegare nesachayas sheaziku, the take of God Yesim at Aracharagal, that they should entice, they should bite and do more than normal. That's enticement. Here, since we're talking about chayas, wild animals, so we have to say here it was more than by chayas, they pushed to send them, there was a stronger, there was shisui. But you can't consider that a ness against the nature, because if it would be, the kasha comes back. So why didn't the Torah mention that ness? It's not a real ness. They bite anyway. They destroy anyway. Elamayit is stronger. So the Torah didn't mention it, but it is a chidush above of what normal they would do. That's what Rashi brings, that Raya Dafke from this posuk, not the posuk in Parsha B'Chakesai, where the posuk says, the Rebbe asked in the beginning, he says, V'ishlachti b'chem as chayas hasodim. Why? First, Rashi is like this. Mashliach means megare. Entice. That is a raya only from a posuk that talks about payments. See, the kasha in the beginning was, if he's bringing a posuk, why doesn't he bring a posuk of chayas, which fits more here? But again, Rashi wants to bring that it means enticement. Where do we know that it is? Because by payment, it's an enticement. Shabom shaykh ikirin in agir. To really entice and to get them angry is more by payments. On their own, they don't destroy. So first, Rasha says it's girui. That's a taich mashliach. Araya mashliach is girui. We find over there by behemoth as araya music. Well, achasha pirish inyan becholos. After he explained what the inyan that klolos the inyan that taich of mashliach. Meisif Rasha lefarish. But in the da Rasha adds that in our case, hagirui beif mashal shis. So us it was tak enticement, but a stronger enticement. Because if it would be regular, you don't have to do it in the chayas. Alpia, now this will explain Shemasha Rasha Mamshik Vipirish of Tevis, Esa'orev. That this that Rasha says, that the word Esa'orev means Kol Mina Chayas Rois, Machoshim Akravim Barbuvia. It means all kinds of wild animals and snakes and scorpions mixed up by Mashchisim Ben, and they were destroying them. But Rasha says that Ein Ikre Lafaret Miho Yiborit. Rasha's interest, not interest to tell us who was the mixture of? Kizema vuyat afke, the tevis mashliach. That we know already, it was animals from the word mashliach, like we said before. So what is Rasha telling us? As sheikra bo leimer, what Rasha is trying to tell us, shekavona sakosa v'tevis ha'orev, that the meaning of the posuk of the word orev, he shebo bar vuvia. That's what he says. The main thing is not the words, chaya yisroes nechoshim akrabim. The main thing is arvuvia. He just says who it was. Kol mini chaya yisroes nechoshim bar vuvia. That's the main point of this market. Obviously, the matzke tells they're coming. But the ness of the market, see, if wild animals come, it's not such a big ness. You can have some time. But they come a lot, and they come all mixed up. That's the ness. Since Rashi wants to write that the order of Misa came mixed, so he already writes who they were, all kinds of wild animals, snakes and scorpions, gives them a fire, shows Arvuvi, shows him a makazu, explains what Arvuvi was. We still don't know where he gets that with snakes and scorpions. We'll see that in a minute. The Locha Maite Gamas Tavis S Orev, that's the one like Ashes was. If he's explaining what the Orev is, why does he bring the Dibra Maskal, the word S? Now we know that. Ashe Bezem Mesiv Hechrech Lei Meshikir Achidu Shoy Shabob Arvuvi. This adds to what we're saying the whole time, and Rashi is trying to tell us that the main chidush is that they came mixed. And that's from the word es. Kidim ein ze ikir achidush, if that wouldn't be the main chidush. Vahu rak prat echad mekol ha-makir, that's a detail of one of the makis, that they came mixed. But that's not the ikir. Eich yitochen leimer, how could he say, hinini mashliya v'cho es ha-orev? And what am I sending to you? The orev. What does that mean? Shemavon eshezeo kol ma shemagarabe. This is all I'm going to do. The orev. That's only from the word es. From the fact that I'm enticing upon you. That proves that this is what the maki is all about, the nest. So this adds to what we said before, that the main nest is the orif, because the Torah says it, but the word es adds to it. So the main ness is the Orev, and that's what Rashi is mighty there. Now we understand why Rashi doesn't specify that they were bears, lions, leopards. We have no proof what kind of wild animals were in that area, were in Mitzrayim or around Mitzrayim. So there's no proof that bears came, lions came, and the leopards came, we don't know. The Imoi Rasha Mefarish Dubi Marais and the Vodim had Rasha said that it was bears, lions, and leopards. Hoya Mashme would seem Sheim Le Nimtso Oz Bisvidis Mitzrayim Evin Akalish Baruch Mokim Rochik Mitzrayim. We don't know where they're. So it would mean if that's what the Eibishter brought, so some of them he would have to bring from someplace far away. But he said, he had Nes Nes, it's another Nes. An animal from Africa all the way down would come to Mitzrayim. Rashi doesn't say what. Probably the lions, that the animals, I mean, that were around Mitzrayim. Without explaining which chayas they were, because we don't know which one they were. The pasha, they were only those that were around that area. So Rashi doesn't say what it is. This will also explain what Rashi says, that he also had snakes and scorpions. Why? The postik zemesayim, the postik finishes off the gamo adomo asherheim aleho, and also let's look back at the postik. The postik says that I'll send you that mashliyah b'chod in the orev umoli botim mitzrayim, they'll fill up the houses of Mitzrayim, the orev, the gamo adomo asherheim aleho, and also the adomo, the earth that they're on. What does that mean? Who's on the earth? That who's on it? If the Pasuk would say, the Orev will fill up the bottom Mitzrayim, and also the land that they're on it, the Pasuk is telling you the Orev. So what would be the Pshat? The Orev. The Orev are going to come, and they will fill up the house and the land that they're on. They'll fill up the whole land. Botem Mitzrayim, he doesn't say Molo Ha'orev Es Botem Mitzrayim. He says Botem Mitzrayim, the houses of Mitzrayim will be full. And he says, as if it would say Molo Botem Mitzrayim Es Ha'orev, Gama Adoma Asher Abatim Eya Mitzrayim Molo Es Ha'orev. It goes on the houses. He says that the Botem Mitzrayim is the Iker, so the Botem Mitzrayim, the Orev is going to be full with the Orev and the Adomo that it is on, which goes on the houses or on the people. The Eid V'Ikir, another ayah that doesn't go on the Adomo that the Orev is on, but it goes on the Adomo that the houses or the Mitzrim are on, because Kol Parsha Zuha Orev Eloshin Yochid. The whole Parsha Orev is singular. If it would mean the land that the Arab is on, she would have said that he is on. And the Pasuk says that it'll fill the land which they are on, meaning they, the houses, or the Mitzrayim. Not only will they fill up the batim and the houses, it'll fill the ground on which the houses stand, or on which the people stand. What does that mean? The Arev is going to be in the ground. The Arev should be in the ground. How could animals be in? It doesn't make sense. It's against nature. And we're saying there's no other nest here. The other things were natural. The nest was the Arvuvia. But as I say, said as Hamutkish, because of Lipniz, it's contradicts what we said before, that there was no extra miracle. The only miracle was the Arev, but not the other things. That is, they were snakes and scorpions. It's natural that they're found inside the pits, inside the holes of underground. We know that already. Even the child who's just starting to learn Chumash, the way the Rebbe learned, remembers everything that he learned. So he learned before. The Pasuk says, they threw him into the pit. It had no water. It doesn't have water, but it had snakes and scorpions. Naturally, they're found in the ground. It's not against their nature, but mainly that's not an extra nest. But still, Rashi doesn't bring. If Rashi is explaining those words, he should have quoted from the Pasuk the words Gam had Adoma Shem Aleo. The Gam Einem Aramzim Bevegamer. He doesn't even say the Gamer to hint to those words. He Ka'omer, like we said, Kan Einikin and Yonah Shel Rashi Lefaret Min Ne'achai Shev Yakadosh Baruch Hu Makaseret. Orif. Rashi is not trying to tell us who the animals were. Kim Lahad Gishabo Barabuvia. The main thing he told me Barabuvia. But Akderech Agav Mefaret Shoy Gam Nechoshim Yakrab. Derech Agav, he tells us they were wild animals. And Rashi has a Hechre, but that's not what he's trying to tell. But the Vaila, he has a Hechre, that there were snakes and scorpions also from the word Hashem Aleha. But he's not being mafarish those words. That's why he doesn't quote them. Om inyan derish beer. So we explain the way to Hashem, but the inyan, not the word. Till now we explain shat in the words. The inyan needs explanation. We said that the main nest here where they came in mixture, what's so special about it? So the main nest and chidish in this makke is that they came by Bavuvia. Why? That's what Rashi continues. The next piece, we said, Bukhura is a separate inyan. But Rashi explains the reason for the makis. So it should be a separate piece of Rashi. No, it's a hemshchut before. Rashi explains, yes, that Nagoda, we find the reason for every makis, why it came this way. Shadli said, by knowing that, you've engaged lachidish about Ore. That'll explain what's the specialty of Ore. And Rashi says like this, the Dachsisa Muhammad Malachim Baalei, by war they come. And what happens? First they close, they ruin the water. Achakach taken Aleim, then they blow, Bairian, the Shafri, they blow Shafri, Liyarim, Olavalam, to destroy, to involve with them, to scare them. Chen Atzvardim, the Karkim Bumin, so the Medrash says, that God says, that same thing, why the second Maki was frogs, because they make a lot of noise. Nimt. So from here it comes out. From here we see one of the plans of the Seder in the war. One of the ways of waging a war is making noise to scare people. Oh, now that we know that, so that explains makasorev. That what? Tam barvuvia. Why did they bring all the animals mixed up? That definitely got them very scared. You see one kind of chayas, people see it, they get scared, but not that much. Many chayas, many kinds, and all mixed up together, that's very scary. So that's what Rashi wants to tell us, that the whole nest was, the whole main thing is Arvuvia. What's so special about it? Look in the Medrash. The Medrash says that by Tzvadim, that's what it is. Since Rashi wants to tell us how important it is, the mixture, Lochem maybe Rashi tamze shel makas kan. That's why Rashi brings the reason for the makas here. Ubehem shel mashakos lifnizer beisad diburin behem shel to what they wrote in the same piece. Or maybe rak tam shel beis makas er sheni is the only reason first two. Kinda rak at latam makas tavadeya. He started there, but he means to bring the first basically to get to the second. But lay yes, he didn't go further. Ki beikir the makim zu mischam Rashi beviim edeshe. Rashi meant tafke this makim. That's why Rashi, when he wants to show the Nimshel how the style of war applies to the Makis, he doesn't tie truth that why dam. We understand it from what Rashi says, because the first thing you do is spoil the water, but Rashi doesn't refer back to the Makis. But that's why Deya he does. Tafkim, when you explain the reason for the Tzvadeya, for the Tzvadim, is to scare them. Oh, so that's a ninyan in doing. We understand Makas Orev. Afa became Mukha Rasha Lahagdim Shatam Zanemer Bagode. Still, Rasha has to start off that this is a reason Agode. Afsha Gamme Pshuta Shumikal Yashmokim Nusfora Zukin Alfid Gimel. Chura in Pshat, we asked the Kasha before. In Derech HaPshat, we can understand such a Svara. The Eivishna went in the Seder of the way it goes with the war. So why can't this be Pshuta Shumikal? Why does Rasha start? This is an Agode. Goes back to what he said before. In Pshat, we're not looking for this as reasons for the Makis. For the Makis, we know the reason before. But Makis, David, Tzvardeya, we know what is the reason. Balkis Yeroso, to punish the God. But Makis Kinim, we said before, why? Laharas Achatumim, Shez Balikimi Kinal, to show them that it's Hashem's finger. So therefore, Velochem Magdim Rashi, Shetam Zeu Bagod, Rashi, that's not the reason I'm giving Pshat. There is an Agada to be found. What Rasha's interest is why they brought what the main thing is, the mixture. So he says, based on what Agoda says in the reason for the Makis, we'll understand it. This pshat in the why he brought Dam and Tzvardeya is not a contradiction against pshat. So Rasha doesn't say that's the pshat because there's no hechach in pshat. But the other three reasons, by Dam Tzvardeya, for the punishing the God, and by Kinim for the Chatumim, that's something that Pshuta Shel Mikra tells us. Rashi said it before. So Rashi says, but according to what it says in Agode, one of the things the Makis was, we see by Tzvardeya, that it's the noise, that explains why the Arvuvye, the mixture of all these wild animals together, made the main thing. But it's not simple, not straight. Afsh ain't the kusher mamish, not a real kasher. Velochen agama bir azer ak nirmiz mekeimik in the comment. The next kasher is going to be a kasher, but not a real kasher. When it's a real kasher, Rashi answers it. Sometimes Rashi, when it's a kasher, not a real kasher, but it needs some explanation, Rashi could be meramis, beremis. So here Rashi is meramis to answer this kasher, not the kasher, but a kasher that we could ask. But who was the kasher? Even though we explained that the fact that they came mixture, that's something that scares them and says it's important. So why Ober Fort? Is this the only thing mentioned in the pasuk? As if saying the fact that they came and they bit and they destroyed, that's not so important. That's a simple. We could see, like we said before, the noise makes it a lot. But that is also a problem. The biting, why does Nathalie not mention that? That's why Rashi finishes off and says that Emes. He doesn't bring more than the first and the second because he's trying to bring the Agoda to the second. That's all he needs. But he finishes off. At the end he says, like it says, Medrash Tanchumen. What does he mean? Look in Tanchumen. What do you see there? Shom, behem shechlinyan anal masupe. There, after he explains the Makis, he says, but it's far them, their noise was worse than the destruction that they did. So we understand. You look there, you'll understand by Orev. That's a very important thing. Kasha is that important more than everything? Yes, it's more than everything. That's why Rashi adds, after he brings the two reasons for Dam and Tzvardeya, he says, etc. What's etc.? When he explains the next Makis. Why does he say etc.? Rasha is only trying to bring the Tzvardeya. But it says later, the other Makis is not Negei at all. So why does Rashi even say B'chulu? She didn't mean and go ahead and see the rest of the makis. Elo Masha Kosev, he means what it says further, that their noise was worse than their destruction. But that's what Asha wants to say, and that's why the whole thing is only audit. According to what we're saying, that Rashi, when he brings the Medrash, this is not the reason why the Makis came. Kiim, the real reason, that was all Derech Agav from the Agada, he says. But the real reason of Pipshat is the first three, Lahalkes Yerosam, to punish the God, Ulaharez Lachatum Shezbadikim, to show the magicians that it's a finger of God, Yuvan Eidinian, will expand and send something else. The Makas Orev Ksiva Chakab, but the Makas Orev, it says, after he told him, I'll bring an Orev, it says, I'm going to separate Geshen, the place where my nation is living, standing, there the Orev won't be there. That means, that there was no Makas Orev by the Yidin. The Kasha is, why doesn't somebody the first three Makas, it wasn't by the Yidin? The movement, if it's self-understood, well, you'd say it's Pashtech, the Makas was for the Mitzrayim, why would it be Vadim? So it's obvious it wasn't Vadim. So why Makas Orev does he have to say it? Now, there are many opinions here. Many people don't even know these opinions. The Ebenezer, writes like this. He says these three Makas, Dam, Tzvadei, and Kinim, included the Yidin also. What do you mean the Eden? The Ibishtha wasn't punishing the Eden, but they weren't so terrible. Like Makas Ha'orev, Shoyse Kosher, from Makas Ha'orev down, that was a terrible Makah. Hashem Hifrish Ben Amitzim Ben Yisrael. That's when Hashem said the Eden shouldn't get it. But the first three Makas, the Eden also had. Omnum Radvaz Vitchubos, the case of the Radvaz writes against the Ebenezre. Ma'ash, the cause of Ebenezre. Kimakas Adam Vatzvadim Vakin Moisel Mitzrayim Uli Yisrael. That the Maki of Dam Tzvadei and Kinim was by the Mitzrim and by the Eden. Osir Lahamin Dovrzeh. It's forbidden to believe that. Kolish Kinsha, certainly that Aksuvim made in Lahep. The Pesukim showed the opposite. The Pesukim say, V'leyochlu Mitzrayim Lishtis M'nayev. By Dam, it says the Mitzrim could not drink from the river. V'yachpur Mitzrayim Tzvivis Ayesh. So they dug around the river. So who says, so what does it say? Who couldn't drink? Mashmav Yisroel, Leo Yisrichim Lazad. The Eden didn't have to dig around. They were drinking for the water. So the Maki of Dam wasn't on them. But Tzvardim Ksiv also says, the Tzvardim will come, Becho, Ba'amecho, you and your nation, the Soro at Tzvardim Becho, and then when it goes away, he says, they're going to go away from you, and Mitecha from your house, and Mevatecha from your servants, and Me'amecha from your nation. So he's talking about the Goyim. Mashmash Lehoi Israel, not about you. Chayna Kinim. Same Bekinim. Yilmet Sosim and Namafurish. Even though it doesn't say Bakini, but it's self-understood, just like those weren't, here also weren't. But Layodaiti, another thing he says as far as, he says first, when the Psukim is Mashma, that the first three were by the Eden. Were not by the Eden, I'm sorry. But besides that, I have a Svara, he said. Im hoiso, amak hoisogam l'Yisrael, if the Makim is also by the Eden, ma raya yesh malapara sheishloch es Yisrael, how would that prove to Pari to send the Eden? The whole purpose of the Makim is to make Pari send the Eden out. If it's by the Eden also, how would that prove to him that the Eden have to go? That it's against him for the benefit of the Eden. But Rambam appears in Mishnah's case, but the Rambam writes differently. He writes, "Makas dam tzvadei alohi b'Yisrael kol dam tzvadei were not by the Eden. Hashem ki makas kinim hoisegam b'hem, but kinim was avalei hoi mitzayim neisam. They were kinim, but they didn't hurt him. But they were kinim. That's what the Rambam learned. Now this is all good, but the Shaila about Rashi learned." Since Rashi doesn't answer this kasha, why it doesn't say by the other makas that it didn't go to the Eden, why it is by makas orev, muchach shows Rashi bepshute shel mikro ya makas reshenis kam Yisrael. Mashmer, since Rashi doesn't say it, mashmer that it was by the Eden. The chayin nirem mashakosik, it seems from the posik where it says by kinim, but he akinom bo'odom ubabheima. The kinim was by a people. Odom stam, people and animals, doesn't say Eden. The Gamein Lamer, Shemakas Kinim Lohoi Mitzayanis, you can't say like the Rambam either, that they had the Makas Kinim, but they didn't hurt them. Kiminolon came in Pshut HaShemikr, where do we get such a thing in Pshat? So Meil HaKorin Terashe, seems like the Makas, the first three were by the Eden also. Ah, Yubin Igei, Lekushas HaRadvaz, the concerning the Radvaz, Kasha, Lomo Matgish HaKosem Mitzrayim, Makas Damet Tzvadeya. So why does the Pasuk in stress by these Makis that like he brought the Rayas? It says the Mitzrayim couldn't drink the water, and by the Tzadim it says it'll come into you. That's not a kasha. That's what the point of the Maki was. It happened by the Eden, but the point is to go on the Mitzrayim. So the Torah mentions what the point is. So that you could answer. The last kasha is a real kasha. If the Maki happened to the Eden also, what kind of raya would it be that Parah should send away the Eden? The Gam, another shayla. Lama ba'emes hoya makas gam Yisrael. Another shayla. Why Taki was the Eden? But why would the makas have to be by the Eden? I'm not beyond now moving based on what we said, the first three, that the real reason in Pshuta Shlomikra by the first two is because to punish David the Zore. And the other one is by the Chatumim, we'll understand it. Since Rashi already said that the first two Makis came to punish their God. That we understand. We'll see that his Avodah Zorah is punished. So you'll understand that Eibishter is Eibishter. Eibishter is the God. The fact that the Yidden also have it, it's still punishing David Zorah. It's no problem. It's still punishing David Zorah. He didn't have it. It's good. He didn't have it. He sees. But it's not against the Tzrayim. It's against the show that he's stronger, that he could change David Zorah. Based on this reason, it had to be by the Eden also, the water of the Eden. Since this was to punish David Zorah, so every place where the Rabbi Dezore is had to be the Makke. If there is a place where the Rabbi Dezore is not hurt, Pare will think if he'll see that part of the water doesn't get punished, oh, so not my whole God is, a piece of my God is not so good, but there's a piece that's good. But there's a piece that didn't get punished. So by the dam, it had to be by every place where there is water, which is Avodah Zorah Mitzrayim, had to become dam. They didn't have the problem. But the purpose was not to punish Mitzrayim, the purpose was to punish Avodah Zorah Mitzrayim. But there is a Makas Kinim, same by Kinim. Since the whole purpose was that the Chatumim, the magician, should see it comes from the Eibishter, the finger of the Eibishter, built in Makbelas. It had to be a Makkah that has no limit. The whole Eretz Mitzrayim had to be all over. If it wouldn't be all over even on the Eden, so you know what they would think? They would say, Shanas is Aldei Mugbolim. They'll say, it's not the Eibishter. It happened through people, Aldei Bnei Adam, people who can't do everything. They could do only some things. They'll say, Meshav Aaron are magicians. Meshomer Bebez Makas HaRashayin is like they said in the first Tamak. So they say, Meshav Aaron did it. They saw that the magician saw that their magic can bring up the kinim. That means that they're limited, they can't do it. So the Chura Tzaray is David. No, they would say. Meshavan brought it, also brought it not all over a specific area and a specific people. Chatum Mitzrayim couldn't bring it up at all, and they could bring it up 60%. But if there's a place where it's not, that means that this is made through somebody who doesn't, not is mobile to do things. It had to be all over. So they see that this is from the Eibishter. So you see that Siad Hashem, they should see, they saw, because there is no limit to this. When it came to Akas Orev, there is no reason to do to the Eden. There it says be placing. So it shows that according to Rashi, the first three Makis talking about the Eden, and it doesn't take away from what the Makis was supposed to accomplish. And by order, the Pasuk says it. But it all fits to the reason, these three things by the first three Makis. The Pnimis Anyonim, let's try to finish it. By the Pnimis Anyonim, Yeshlemer Atam, Mashahoya, Viflesi, Dafki, Makis, Orev, of the Pnimis, why is there, the Pasuk say that the separation, and the, according to Rashi, that's how it actually happened, that the separation between Yidden and Goyim only by Orev, started from Orev, but not before Apipnimius. In the first three Makas, there was no reason to separate between the Eden and Mitzrayim. Why? Even if the makis happened on the Eden, no one would think that this should be any indication that the Eden could mix with the Goyim. Why would I, David, should give it to the Eden also good? It doesn't show that you're equal. You could mix. Shank if a makas orev came to orev sheirev hakadosh baruch hu zabalachayim David should mix the animals. How you also mock him on machshav eschutz a person could think it's stupid to orev shekiilu heiser hakadosh baruch hu zkolam mechitzas oh David should took away all the borders kameisha heiser as a mechitzah min chayil chayil nochash vakrav he took away the mechitzah from one animal to another from snakes scorpions. The mele nifras gam hageder ben yisro lamim lahavil the mele even might think that oh now there's no more geder no more mechitzah no more separation between us. David wanted to show that even when the in one area the mechitza was taken away, but not in everything, not between Yidden and Goyim. I'm going to separate the place asher ami emedaleh, where my nation is. I'm going to make the separation. I'm going to salvation for the Yidden, and it'll separate. So here the Torah wants to stress that don't think that the mechitza was taken away. The lesson is simple. I want to say that this sicha was sai when it was the Rebbe said in Tovshin Lamed Beis, sai when it was printed, there was Magia in Tovshin Lamed Gimel. It was the time, the beginning of the height of the Rebbe's war against the Mi Yehudi Gzeire. The Mi Yehudi that you accept in Eretz Yisrael Goyim as Yidden. And the Rebbe kept on talking every Fabrengen that you're taking away the Mechitza between Yidden and Goyim. So here the Rebbe put this in. But here you see the Eibush took away the mechitzah of an animal, but not the mechitzah of the Yidden and Goyim. So the Yiroi is, Tafki b'sho asher avuv yibaylam, a time when the world is mixed up. This fits to nowadays also. Obizman asher portsu gidre shalaylam b'eifin shalhoi leilomim. The time like now, the Rebbe says, which the gedorim of the world is completely broken, something that was never. Yesh seirich mayuchet l'chazek es ha-mechitzah ben Yisroel amin, she ben Yisroel amin. Now we need to strengthen the mechitzah between Yidden and Goyim. Sharei gamos, even then, they were in Mitzrayim before Matan Torah. Before the Eibush chose us. Because when we say these words, in Shulchan Aruch it says, you have to have in mind Matan Torah. So Matan Torah when the Eibush chose us. So this was before Matan Torah. It was Orev, a mixture. There was a possibility of thinking that they might mix Yidden and Goyim. Also, HaKadosh Baruch Hu Nes Meyuched. David made a separate Nes. Losom v'duz v'iname b'in amcho to make a separation between Yidden and Goyim. Lachz kama v'kama b'zman neinu zeh, certainly now. V'inyan d'avdol v'duzu ho yibinigei l'kolecha pechet b'nei Yisrael. And this separation has been negated every Yid. Not between the good Yidden, the best Yidden, and the Goyim. Afil b'nigei eilish l'irot z'lotzis m'mitzrayim. There were Yidden who didn't want to go out of Mitzrayim. And at this market, there was a separation between them and the Goyim. This shows this separation of every Yid is a Yid. Because some people are tiny. Anyway, the Fraya Yidin anyway. What do we get? The Fruma Yidin are not going to be affected by the fact that in the Israeli law it says, again, doesn't say the word Kealocha. That's what the Rebbe was fighting. So they said, some people said, who are we afraid? The Fruma Yidin, who cares what they write? Elamai, the Fraya Yidin might take it. Who cares about the Fraya Yidin? The Rebbe says, here we see. David made this mechitza al pines. He made this mechitza between all the Yidden and the Mitzrayim, and all the Yidden included bad Yidden, people who didn't even want to go out of Mitzrayim. Kasher b'nei Yisrael yichaske mechitza zu, and the Yidden will bechazer straighten this mechitza, this wall. Leiti yeshu mechitza v'dover amapil chatzos shalom in hakadosh baruch hu b'nei Yisrael. There will be no wall between David and Yidden. Kol echad v'achas me Yisrael yoshev v'tshuv v'shleima. Everyone, every Yid. Every man, woman of the Eden will do tshuva, shleim, complete tshuva. Mayad hain the golem, the gula, amitis, vashleim, the Mashiach, the Kena, they will be redeemed right away, and the gula, amitis, vashleim, through Mashiach, the Kena. Very fast, but if you think back, the Rashi, and you do it, this is mamish, a puzzle that all the pieces fit. It's mamish. Yeah, that's it. Okay.
Shkoyach.
Thank you.